A ball suspended by a thread swings in a vertical plane so that its acceleration in the extreme position and the lowest position are equal. Find the angle of deflection from vertical at the extreme position. It is given that a pendulum sort of thing, that is a particle which is suspended by a thread, it swings. And this is the vertical position while it is passing through. It will be having some velocity v. And this is the extreme position where it is momentarily at rest. If you draw the force diagrams, what are the forces acting? At this moment, the force mg will be acting and this will be the tension T. Then what will happen? As the velocity is zero, there is no requirement of centripetal force at this exact location where we are calling it the extreme position. Then this will be theta, as they are saying that the angle with the vertical at the extreme position. We have to find out this angle theta. Just see that, find the angle of deflection from the vertical at the extreme position. Then if you resolve this mg into two components, you are able to see this is mg cos theta, this is mg sin theta. So mg cos theta will be counterbalanced by the tension. Then what is the net unbalanced force? This is mg sin theta. Hence, the acceleration at the extreme position, we can say this is equal to g sin theta. Now when it comes here and it is already passing through a certain velocity, let us see what is this velocity by using energy conservation. For that, let us draw a perpendicular here. What is this? This is, let's say, the length of the thread. So if this is L, then what will happen that we can say this particular length is equal to L cos theta. Then this particular portion remaining, it will be equal to the total L minus L cos theta. That means this will be equal to L minus L cos theta. Hence, if I take this as my reference level, while the particle was passing through the lowest position, I am taking this as the reference level, then the gravitational potential energy at this particular reference level will be assumed to be zero. Then with that reference level, the gravitational potential energy at this particular initial position will be equal to mg into this particular height. And the height is nothing but L minus L cos theta. And there is no kinetic energy because extreme position, the particle is at rest. And when it is passing through this lowest position, at the reference level, the gravitational potential energy is zero. It is only having kinetic energy, that is half mv square. And from there, we can cancel m. It will be g. One of the L gets common. So 1 minus cos theta, this is equal to half v square. And as it is already in circular motion, then what is the acceleration at the lowest position? The acceleration at the lowest position is centripetal acceleration. It is v square by r, that is v square by L. Now, as per the question, they are saying that these two accelerations are identical. They are exactly same. Therefore, g sin theta is equal to v square by L as per condition. Now, what is v square by L? I hope we can get something from here. So let's put g sin theta is equal to, here v square by L will be equal to 2g 1 minus cos theta. Now I hope theta is never zero. Therefore, I can afford to little simplify this after cancelling small g. This sin theta I am trying to do like this. 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. And 2 is already there. And this 1 minus cos theta I am trying to do as 2 sin square theta by 2. As theta is not 0, therefore I can afford to cancel one of the sin theta by 2, and from there you are able to observe that this is tan theta by 2 is equal to half, theta by 2 is tan inverse half, theta is equal to 2 times tan inverse half, that is the angle sought for this particular example.